Hello and welcome to another video on my channel, Coastal Mad Ian on YouTube. Today I am at Alton Towers to experience their Scarefest 2022. I can't wait for this event. Last year it was really good. Got into the attic and everything. Altonville Mine Tours wasn't that good last year, so hopefully that has improved this year. I'm here for 2 days, so let's go. First ride of the day is on Smiler, and also Alton Towers is open till 9 o'clock tonight. That's really good to see. I'm sure that was closed at like 7, I think, last year. That's really good to see that they have longened up the day. So night rides later on in the day. So can't wait for that, to get on Wicker Man and also to get on Nemesis as well in the dark for the last time this season. So let's go and see you when I get up to X Sector to go and ride the Smiler. Let's go. So I just walked past Nemesis Subterra in Forbidden Valley, and they are working on it. I don't know if it is coming back. I didn't actually experience it when it was Nemesis Subterra, so hopefully it will come back, because they're doing a lot of work, especially when Nemesis is closing next year due to refurbishment. So hopefully we will see Nemesis Subterra coming back for the next year, but I don't know what they're doing to it, so keep you updated. So they have got Patrick's Trick or Treat Party, Alton Ancestors Final Haunt, the Sin Bin Elemental to Hell, Phil's Halloween Dance Party, and a Vintage Halloween. So this is today's shows. Quite a lot to offer here at Alton Towers, quite a lot of times as well, so very good to see loads of shows here for the Halloween. And they are really decent shows as well, brilliant for the families and the kids as well. I can't wait to go and check them out later on. A little bit of footage there from the Ancestors for this year. Glad to see them back in here at Alton Towers. They always brighten up the mood for Scarefest. They're a really good dance show as well, good dance act, and really worth watching when you come to here at Alton Towers. I'm just on Main Street at the moment with all the pumpkins back here for Halloween. They have been coming back for quite some time now. And it looks really nice here at Tower Street. So as you can see over there in the background, there is construction happening here for the fireworks 2022. Unfortunately, I won't be able to come here for the fireworks because it is on a Saturday, Sunday. It looks really big, like four structures on the all the lawns here on Tower Street. So hopefully it will be a really good event this year. Just come off of Smiler here at Alton Towers, my first ride of the day. Really well running and really well. Not as much hang time this time though, on the older inversions, but running like, she's not rough at all. Gliding around the track, And yeah, just a beautiful coaster. Still sits at my number one spot in the UK on roller coasters. But yeah, really good ride to start off the day. It is quite busy here at Alton Towers today. But yeah, it's all right. It's not too bad and it's not too quiet. It's just nice. So I'm just standing outside Enterprise now. As you all may know, unfortunately, Enterprise has left the park. Unfortunately, one of the classics here at Alton Towers. Yeah, we had to say farewell to it a few days ago. It is so unfortunate, really. We have still got Zodiac here at Full Park. But yeah, Enterprise has been here for years, and it's so sad to see one of the classic flat rides go from this park. Hopefully we'll be able to see improvements and developments for next year, but yeah, so sad to see Enterprise go from the park. We have still got the Blade, which was which is a big classic here at Alton Towers. But yeah, we have got the Retro Squad here at Alton Towers, so we can go on this. Quite a few fairground rides here. So hopefully, yeah, they will still keep coming and developing. But we need to see another flat ride, the permanent flat ride here at Alton Towers, because they have not really got many. Except the children's rides. But yeah, having a good second day here at Alton Towers. I'm just going to go on my horrible ride now, Spin Jam here at Alton Towers, which will replace Mixtape, which is now at Hyde Park Winter Wonderland. So I'll be able to go and ride that at Winter Wonderland. So yeah, let's go and have a ride on Spin Jam. Let's go. Queen of Speed now. It had a busy queue yesterday, so yeah, it's only on a 15 minute queue at the moment. So yeah, let's go for a ride on Rita, Queen of Speed. Let's go. Just come off of 13. If you go down to the woods today, you better not go alone. Whoa. Yeah, really good ride. For some reason, it had a brake on the lift hill, on the drop as you go down on the first drop. For some reason, it was a really good ride, really smooth as well. Really good roller coaster, and yeah, I really want to get it in the dark later on in the day. So this is a bit more look to the fireworks here at Alton Towers. So they have got one here, one here, one here, and one here. So yeah, I think we're hoping for it to be a really big show for fireworks this year. Unfortunately, like I said earlier, I won't be here for fireworks. Unfortunately, I really want to go and experience it one day. But yeah, it looks a really big setup for fireworks this year. So yeah. Let's party! Nice Christmas! Here we go! Oh my God, we're back again! Oh yes we are! Brothers, sisters, everybody say! Gonna bring the flame, I'll show you how! Got a question for you, better answer now! Yeah, everybody, rock the ball.
it is very spooky. Oh. There might be ghosties and ghoulies and monsters. Sorry, everyone. I didn't mean us. I meant the really scary monsters.
Oh, ow, scare me.
I've just filmed a bit of footage there from the Patchy's Halloween party. Really good show, the same as last year, full of characters, full of energy, and really putting up the vibes. They are quite kid shows really, but family shows. They're not too scary at all, but yeah, really good dancing there, and the same actors from last year. But yeah, really good show and worth coming to watch when you come to Alton Towers. Yeah, so that was Patchy's Halloween party. So Tower Street absolutely looks incredible, really well themed, coming into the park. Yeah, it always is so well themed to all the events this year already done. Yeah, but it's absolutely amazing. The tower's just behind it as well. As you walk into the park, it's amazing. So well themed, so many pumpkins around as well, and straw bales and that, really nice. And it's even better in the dark as well later on in the evening. But yeah, so nice to walk onto Tower Street at Scarefest. So well themed. And the massive sign as well back down there, saying Scarefest on it. And the car as well in the middle, which comes back every year. Also all the ride pumpkins as well really add up to the atmosphere as well. They have been coming back for years now, but yeah, they're really nice to see and take photos of. So I'm just in Towers Trading now, looking at the new merch, what they have got for this year. They have got quite a bit actually of new merch, so 15 years of Scarefest this year, and a little top for the from all the actors and everything. Some really nice mugs, £12, which has got a pumpkin on it and says Halloween on it. They have got a nice hoodie this year, saying Halloween at the back of it, so that's really nice, really bright colours as well. Another nice t-shirt from Scarefest, and the woolly hats as well. Yeah, and all the actors as well. Take Plushies Home, I think they're called. Yeah, really nice choice of merchandise this year. So, for Halloween as well, CBeebies Land has also got shows going on throughout the day as well for Halloween. So, yeah, if you don't like the big shows, you can also go and watch the kids shows as well, if you have got young children. So that's really good to see that they're doing it for everyone. Yeah, so CBeebies Land is really good for the kids. It's a massive area. So, yeah. Just gonna head towards Wicker Man now, Feed the Flames. Yeah, this ride is really good in the dark. So join me when I get to Wicker Man. So just queuing up for Wicker Man now, Feed the Flames. It's on a 45 minute queue.
But yeah, they do get this train, they do get the trains out really quickly as well. Wicker Man has done really well with their operations this year. So hopefully it won't be too long. See you after. Come off, Wicker Man. Come off of Wicker Man here at Alton Towers. Oh my god, that was amazing. Honestly, I think that was one of the best rides I had on Wicker Man this season. So much airtime on that. Really smooth as well for a Woody. A lot of faults to it as well. Just everything you would expect in a Woody and more. Can't wait to get back on that later when it's dark, because that will literally fling around the track. Honestly, that was really fast. Really happy with it. The mist was all on as well. The pre-show was obviously really nice as well to see. It does slow it down a bit. It does slow the operations down a bit. But yeah, running on a free train service. Really, really good operations on Wicker Man. Really getting them trains out as well. But yeah, absolutely amazing ride on that. Honestly, one of the best rides I've probably had on Wicker Man. And yeah, incredible. Can't wait to see it in the dark later on in the day. Yeah, this evening. Gonna head towards Nemesis now and Galactica in Forbidden Valley. Going on to the other side of the park now, and see when I get down to Forbidden Valley. Footage in there from the dancers, a new show for 2022 here at Scarefest. Yeah, really good. I only saw a little bit of that, but yeah, really good dancers, really good singers as well. Yeah, Alton Towers does put some really good shows on here for their events this year. So yeah, so it's amazing. So just going into the trick or treat town with Haribo. It's sponsored by Haribo, so yeah, they get given a good nice bag. It's £9.60 for Merlin pass holders, and it's also £12 for the general public. So yeah, really nice sign to out of it. So yeah, haven't done this before, so let's go and find out what this event is. I've just come out of the Trick or Treat Town, sponsored by Haribo's with Haribo's. Yeah, awesome event that was. Really good walkthrough attraction that was. So many jump scares as well in that. Great for the families as well. And it's awesome. So well themed. Honestly, really colourful, really well thought of as well. And a really long attraction. Yeah, so really good. And really colourful, and you have to like knock on doors and that, and it's either a trick or a treat, so that's pretty cool. And there's so many actors in that as well. They're not scary, and it's really, really well thought of. Yeah, so like I said before we went in, it's £9.60 for Merlin pass holders and £12 for the general public. In my opinion, I think that is a bit pricey for what you get, but in and all, it is a theme park, and it's a really good attraction, especially for the families. So. just in the queue for Nemesis. Sit back, it's fright time. Yeah, unfortunately, it is coming to the end of the season now, and it means that Nemesis is closing for next season, unfortunately. It has been announced outside the whole ride. Even the staff are wearing nice clothing, and it's for the best, really. Hopefully she will be better, because she is getting rough now. Nemesis has been at the park for a long time now, since 1994 I think it is. It was my number one for a long time. It's really intense ride, and really good ride, and hopefully it'd be really not good today to get back on her. Hopefully she's running really well. She has been really rough this season, and hopefully it will come back and really intense again, like it was to start off with. Yeah, so I'm in the queue for Nemesis, and see you after I come off Nemesis. We have got a closing date for Nemesis. It's the 6th of the 11th, 2022. It's such a shame, but it is for the best for this coaster. It has been here a long time. It has been here a very long time. One of the first intense coasters in the UK, and a John Wardley classic as well. So hopefully they will keep in contact with it. But yeah, really good to see it being refurbed and sanded down to make it longer at the park, because we wouldn't want to see it going, because it is such an iconic ride. So yeah, let's get a ride on Nemesis. And you can tell it's closing, because it's on a 45 minute queue. So yeah, it's amazing. Just come off of Nemesis here at Alton Towers. Really good ride on that. I can see why she definitely does need a retrack. She is riding well, Nemesis is, but yeah, it definitely does need that retrack, because it is very jolty now. B&M isn't meant to be like really jolty, but still really good, impressive ride on her. She's still really high in my rankings for top UK, I think. But yeah, still a really good iconic ride. All the loops are really good. All the inversions are really good as well. And yeah, just a really good ride. I have noticed that they have put a lot of red lighting around Nemesis, which makes it brighter as well. So yeah, really good ride on the old classic Nemesis here at Alton Towers. So as you can tell by the music, I am now queuing for Galactica, the other B&M flying coaster in this area, Forbidden Valley, Journey Beyond. I really like Galactica, doesn't beat Fly at Fantasyland. But yeah, a really good coaster still, and it's only on a 35 minute queue, so let's go. just having a ride on the park's pirate ship called Blade. One of the only flat rides, one of the main flat rides here at Alton Towers. Unfortunately, Ripsaw is gone from the park. But yeah, they have got all the retro shrug rides here, like Spin Jam and Mixed. Spin Jam and a few in Gapes Granny, the area of David Williams. So yeah. Yeah, I think this is a really good pirate ship, so see you after I've come off Blade. The most unreliable ride at Alton Towers is testing. Yeah, it hasn't been open quite a long time. So yeah, they're finally testing it. So hopefully it'll be open. Well, I just come off of Funk and Fly here at Alton Towers. One of the most unreliable rides here at Alton Towers. Yeah, really good ride. It was on its longest cycle as well. Yeah, just a really good ride. Made me really dizzy as well, made me nearly feel sick. The first time I rode it, oh my god, that was intense. But yeah, it's a really good ride and worth going on it when you come to Alton Towers. It is one of the retro rides here, but yeah, it's finally opened at 4 o'clock. So yeah, that was really good. Watched another dance show from Alton Towers here on the main stage. Absolutely amazing, really incredible. Really put a lot of effort into them as well. The shows were really good, the actors were really good, engaging with the public as well. And just for really good shows, Alton Towers really puts on. At all of the events I have done this year, the shows have been incredible. I think that is all the shows now at Alton Towers on the main stage. So yeah, it's just time for the scare mazes now. I'm just gonna go and have a ride on Heads Back, Hold Tight, here we go. Of course it's Spinball Wizard. Yeah, let's go on Spinball Wizard. Woo! Just noticed in the Spinball Wizard queue line is all the games and that, what they used to have in the queue lines, have vanished for some reason. I really don't know why. It's such a shame because you used to be able to press the buttons and they used to do something, like the ball dropped into the hole or something. Like, yeah, but they have seemed to get rid of them. So yeah, hopefully they will come back. Just had a quick bite to eat, bratwurst, which is still here. They're all here all season. Really nice German sausage and a cider. And I've just come off of Spinball Wizard. Yeah, really good ride that was. Yeah, didn't spin as much that time though. But yeah, it was just a really fun ride. Spinball Wizard is. Still prefer Dragon's Fury at Chessington. Well, the time has come for the scare mazes now. Yeah, I cannot wait to kick this season off at Alton Towers Scarefest. So yeah, here goes my first scare maze. It's going to be Darkest Steps. Yeah, so I'm just going to go and head towards Darkest Steps now. One of the returning mazes for this year. So hopefully it won't fail to disappoint. See you when I come off Darkest Steps.
We must stay together as a group.
Well, I've just experienced Darkest Steps for my first scare maze of the season. Oh my god, what a great start to have from the season. Honestly, so many jump scares in that. Oh my god, absolutely amazing. I was screaming all the way. I was led the group as well. And yeah, four scares, four of jump scares, and honestly one of the most incredible mazes I've probably ever done. Yeah, and that was one of the smaller scare mazes as well, like one of the family ones. But yeah, the crack'em at the end, oh my god, got me. Good, that did. But absolutely amazing start. Also to Alton Towers as well, and yeah, I don't mind them bringing back mazes from years, but that was incredible, honestly, absolutely amazing. So full of theming, loads of jump scares, loads of scare actors as well, the smell pods, the animatronics as well, the crack'em at the end as well. Honestly, one of the most incredible mazes Alton Towers has done. So yeah, my next one is the Attic Terror of the Towers. This was one of my favourite mazes last year, and hopefully it doesn't fail to disappoint. So there, let's go to the Attic Terror of the Towers. Whoa. Just came out of the Attic Terror of the Towers here at Alton Towers. Absolutely amazing. What I would say though is it has lacked a few scare actors, but talking to the person outside, they had a few problems yesterday with queue jumpers and everything, so the actors, they have really leashed out on the actors. But yeah, the actors what were in there were incredible, honestly, loads of jump scares in that maze. But yeah, Darkest Steps still is my number one at the moment out of the two. But yeah, absolutely incredible. I love this storyline to it. I love all the theming and how much detail Alton Towers goes into all these scare mazes, because it's absolutely amazing. It's actually a real house they're making into, and yeah, amazing. So Darkest Steps still is my favourite at the moment. But yeah, the actors' quality to these mazes are really good as well. Always there to scare you. But yeah, the Attic did lack a little bit of like dark corridors with no actors there. So that could be an improvement for them. But yeah, really good. So my next maze I'm going to is the Ottenville Mantles. Really good maze last year. Well, it wasn't actually, it wasn't as good as it could be, but hopefully it will live up to its standards this year. Let's go to the Alton Beyond Man Tours. Let's go. So it's starting to get dark here at Alton Towers now. I'm just going to kind of have a ride on Don't Look Down, the first vertical drop roller coaster. Oblivion. Yeah, sunset ride. Oblivion is today. It's on a 30 minute queue. But yeah, let's go. Having a break from the mazes for a bit. And then I'm off to Alton Beyond Man Tours after this. So yeah, let's go on Oblivion. Don't Look Down. Let's go. Woo. Just came off of Oblivion here at Alton Towers. Don't Look Down. Yeah, absolutely amazing coaster. It didn't seem that forceful than I experienced it before. But yeah, awesome. Honestly, amazing coaster. So now it is time to go into the Alton Beyond Man Tours. Yeah, amazing mazes. So hopefully it will lead up to my expectation. So let's go in the mines at Alton Towers. Woo! Let's go. I am crying. Hey, did you happen to see the most beautiful girl in the world? And was she crying? Yeah, Alton Beyond Man Tours. Yeah, let's go.
Passed down for generations in the Schubert family all the way until 1977 when the mines closed.
So I've just come out of the Alton Beyond Mine Tours here at Alton Towers. Oh my god, that was horrible. That was appalling. Honestly, the actors just weren't there. Unfortunately, I don't want to give it too much of a bad review, but that was appalling. I didn't scream once in that maze. Unfortunately, they had a lot of problems yesterday, apparently, due to the scare actors not being here. But yeah, honestly, that was appalling, and hopefully they will sort that out soon, because it just wasn't their best at all, that maze. The first year I did it was amazing. That was my favourite maze, but it's just coming back every single year, and it's just ridiculous. It wasn't as good last year, but it was even worse this year. The smell pods were there though, and still the same maze. Like, it's still the same maze, nothing's changed in it. So hopefully they will refurb it or bring back a new maze for the next year, because yeah, it's had its time now, and I think it needs to go and get refurbed to another maze. I would like to see another maze here at Alton Towers, a brand new maze. But yeah, I don't mind them coming back, Maisie's coming back, but they need to be top class than it was the first year I did it. So yeah, that is my opinion on Alton Beyond Man Tours. Wasn't what I was expecting at all, and hopefully they sort themselves out, Alton Towers, seriously. Because yeah, it just wasn't there. It just wasn't my favourite at all. So yeah, just going to do my final maze now, the new one for 2022, the Invitation. So yeah, don't know anything about this maze whatsoever, so I'm going in there with high hopes for this maze. So yeah, let's go to the Invitation. See you when I come out. It's a good start part to the invitation with the amount of scenery outside of it. So yeah, hopefully this is going to be Alton. See you when I come out of the invitation. So, just came out of the invitation here at Alton Towers, the brand new experience of 2022. Yeah, it was okay. I don't know what way Alton Towers is coming with this one, but yeah, it was an audio thing. It wasn't as such a scare maze. It was going into and listening through headphones. So yeah, I don't know what Alton Towers is going this year with Friday Night at Scarefest, but yeah, it was all right. It wasn't scary at all, but yeah, it was all right. Really good scenery going onto the scare maze, but yeah, it wasn't good. I just don't understand how Alton Towers is going this year, but yeah, it was all right. Nothing special, in fact. But yeah, Darkest Steps has been my all-time favourite maze tonight at here at Alton Towers. Really good. Darkest Steps have been this year amazing. So yeah, followed by the Attic, Terror of the Towers, Altonville Mine Tours, and then the Invitation. But yeah, I don't understand how Alton Towers is going from this year, but still good. At least that's all the scare maze he's done now. We have got literally half an hour left of the park till it closes. So I'm just going to go and rush towards Nemesis, get a night ride on that, and Wicker Man to end the day. Let's go. So just having a walk around the Whispering Souls here at Alton Towers. Really nice last year. So yeah, so beautiful. Honestly, the gardens itself is really nice, but with all the lights and everything, it's really nice. So I've just walked through the Whispering Souls here at Alton Towers, the gardens walkthrough with all the lights and everything. Same as last year, really good still though, and really impressed with it. Shame I had to rush, but yeah, it was a really good attraction still, worth walking through when you come to Alton Towers. Yeah, it's just... But I would like to do Lightphobia here at Alton Towers one day with their Christmas event, because I think that would be amazing. But yeah, I don't know yet. But yeah, I'm going to head towards Billingham Valley now here at Alton Towers. Let's go. Just queuing up for Nemesis, the final night ride of the season, and next season is going into refurb, so it's so glad that I'm getting on Nemesis in the dark, and then yeah, say goodbye to it. Obviously I will be on it tomorrow, but in the light. So yeah, it's so good in the dark, and hopefully I'll get back row. because that is the most best row on Nemesis. So yeah, let's go on Nemesis. So my last ride of the day here on Wicker Man in the dark. Absolutely amazing lighting package Wicker Man has at night, with all the lasers and everything. The real fire coming up from the shoulders of Big Bob. And all the screams look incredible. Running really well as well. So it was absolutely flying around the track earlier. So this is going to be incredible. So yeah, can't wait to ride this. So see you after I come off Wicker Man and end this day at Alton Towers Scarefest 2022. Let's go. Just come off of Wicker Man, a GCI wooden roller coaster here at Alton Towers in the dark, to finish the day off at Alton Towers Scarefest 2022. What an awesome day I've had today. Honestly, it's been amazing. So it's really good in the dark. It was good earlier in the light, but even better in the dark. The lightning package on Big Bob is awesome. All the fire and all the smoke really adds up to the experience. Unfortunately, it did break down. We had to wait quite a long time for it, but it was well worth the wait here at Alton Towers. It's absolutely amazing. It's one of my favourite coasters here at Alton Towers. And it never fails to disappoint. The lightning package on that is absolutely incredible. So it really does make up the experience here on Wicker Man. So yeah, just gonna walk on Tower Street to end this amazing day at Alton Towers and wrap up the vlog here on my channel. Let's go. Well, it's come to the end of the day here at Alton Towers Scarefest 2022. What an amazing day it has been today, getting back on all the rides and all the scare mazes. It's been an incredible day today. I got on really everything except from Rita today from the roller coasters. It's been awesome. All the rides have been really good, really forceful as well. And to end that day here at Wicker Man, in the dark. Also, Nemesis in the dark as well has been absolutely amazing. Gonna miss her so much next year when she's going into maintenance. All the mazes have been really good today. Shame about Altonville Mine Tours, that has let me down a bit. Lack of scare actors, unfortunately. But Darkest Steps, oh my God, was amazing today. That has definitely been my favourite maze today. And really good that I started on that, because it starts off the season really well as well. The Trick or Treat Town has been really good as well. Upcharge attraction, I would, in my opinion, say that they should put that down a bit. £12 is a bit pricey, in my opinion. But yeah, that's Alton Towers for you. All the shows have been really good. All the dance shows have been really energetic, and the actors have really been really well today. Like all the dance shows, all the singers really make up the vibes here at Alton Towers. And just the park in general has been really nice. 9 o'clock closure today, really long day today. So yeah, really good day today. So if you have liked this video, don't forget to like and subscribe so you never miss out on another video. Click that bell notification so you never miss out. And until the next one, guys, you've been watching Coast Meridian. Let's start this season off on a high note. Scarefest 2022 has come to an end. See you in the next one, guys. Bye.
Bye, Towers.